Beginning of chapter 7, we are dealing now with the last stage of Paschal Lamb. We discussed in the past the process of bringing a Paschal Lamb. Bring the offering, there is a process of getting to the final stage of the slaughtering, bringing it. And then the Torah instructed us and said, Al tochlu mimenu na, do not eat from the Paschal lamb while it's fresh meat, meaning not fully, not ready. Ubashel mevushal b'mayim, that it's only cooked with the water. Ki im tzli esh, only roasted by fire, is like you're doing barbecue and you're roasting the whatever it is, the meat on fire. Rosho, the head, al kra'av ve'al kirbo. Imagine you take for example, in our simple language, you have let's say a chicken. Mm-hmm. So you have the meat part and you have the legs, and you combine all of that as one piece. So the Torah instructed us to roast the Paschal lamb all together. Now, the Meiri tells us that in order to do it properly, we need, for example, to cut the leg part and then combine it together as one unit of roasting it. Now, this is a little different between the opinion of how and what exactly the Torah meant. What is the exact tradition? Does that mean that we should do all the process of preparations, including cutting some part of the meat, and then wrapping up as one piece and roasting it? Or we just hang it, the slaughtered animal there, and roasting it as is? Since particularly the Torah used the term head, rosho, al kra'av ve'al kirbo, the middle part, the intestine, and the rest of the meat. So, what we need to clarify before we go to the Mishnah is what the Torah meant by roasting it. How should a person, in a final stage, roasted at me, what type of material he should use, such as the iron plate to use, what materials, and also what is the final stage before you're feeding people, how exactly it's supposed to take place. So the Mishnah, we are on page 74. Keitzad tzolin et ha-Pesach. How does one roast the Paschal lamb? Mevi'in shapud shel rimon. The one bring a spit of pomegranate wood. The Gemara explained why we use pomegranate. V'tochavo letoch piv, and you put it inside the mouth. Remember, the animal is dead, right? Ad beit nekuvato, which means from the mouth of the lamb until reaches its anus, which means the very end. Venoten et kra'av v'dnei me'av letocho, which means he puts its leg and the other part of the body inside it, and then he roasted all together, which means all the pieces he put inside the body toward the mouth, and they are there, so he wrap up everything, and that's what the Torah meant, what Rashi said, Tzli esh rosho al kra'a v'al kirbo, that you combine all of that. Who said that? Divrei Rabbi Yosei Aglili. Rabbi Akiva Omer, Kemin bishul huze. When you do it different. You not insert its leg and the other part inside. But you do it in some type of cooking, which means you place inside the offering like you're cooking it in a way that you suspend the leg and the entrails from the spit above the animal's head outside it. So it's above the head. It's like you have this helmet that you put like in the army, and it looks like gdi mekulas at the top of the head of the animals, and they are basically in that sense they are under the head of the animal. Ein solin et haPesach, the last part of the Mishnah. One may not roast the Paschal lamb, lo ala shapud, velo ala askela, not on the metal spit, not on the metal grill. So the reason is because one part get warm, the other part get warm too, and then the roasted of the meat is basically made by the grill.
Yeah, by the metal, because the metal gets hot.
Amar Rabbi Tzadok, Maase Berabban Gamliel Shamar Letavi Avdo, Tse Utzle Lanu Et HaPesach Ala Askela. He said that it's a story that Rabban Gamliel said to Tavi, his servant, go and roast the Paschal lamb on the grill. So that's basically contradiction. The Gemara explained it. Now we go to the Gemara itself. V'neitei shel matechet. So what's the story? Let them bring a metal spit. Why we said that they have to make it a pomegranate? So they said, Aide decham miktzato cham kulo. Because part that it's open at the top of the fire, so also the other part that is covered with the meat will be warm. It's meaning the kamitvei mechamat hashapud, which means that it's not direct connection of the fire, but go from the grill. The Rachmana and the Almighty said in the Torah, Amar tzli esh velo tzali mechamat davar acher. Torah said that you should roast it with fire and nothing else. V'neite shel dekel. So how about they use a spit of palm wood? Aite de itle shibei, since the palm branch has grooves between the leaves, mapik maya, have kemevushal. It gives off a small amount of water from the grooves doing roasting, and it's considering like it's cook. V'neitei shel te'ena. So how about if we bring spit of fig wood? So the Gemara said, Aide dimchalchel. Since it's hollow and has sap inside, mapik maya, v'havelei kemevushal. It gives off water, and as though the meat is cooked. V'neitei shel alon. Let them bring a spit made from an oak, shel charuv, from a carob tree, or from shel shikma, a sycamore, right? Aide de it be kitre, since they have there a knot, and one must cut them off in order to smooth the branch, mapik maya, that's coming out the water to the knife, and it's considering like it's cooked. So the Gemara said, Shorimon namayit bekitre. So if that's the case, you have the same issue with the pomegranate, that they have those nuts. Shi'ei kitre. So they said, well, the pomegranate is, it's very
smooth.
Thank you. So you don't need to cut them. V'bayit eima. Another option is, benavga bar shata delet bekitre. talking about something new, it's only 1 year old. It's not, doesn't have those nut. Ve'aika be'fasake, but it's still a place between the branch and the tree, and also the bringing out water from the meat to this cut. De'mapik le've'fasake leva. He brings it outside of the mouth of the animals, and it's not coming in the meat. So now he said, Matnitin de lo karabi Yuda. Mishnah, the Mishnah is not according to opinion of Rabbi Yuda de Tanya. Rabbi Yuda omer, Keshem she shaput shel etz eno nisraf, just as part of the spit of wood that is inside the animal is not burned, although it is over the fire. Kach shaput shel matechet, so the part of speed metal that it's inside the animal, a no martiach, does not become burning hot. So the meat is not roasted from the heat. Amru lo, the sages said to Rabbi Yuda, ze cham miktzato, cham kulo, ve ze cham miktzato, eino cham kulo. This one, the shaput that made out of metal, so they're bringing the heat and all that part, it's heat partially, and it creates the heat, but the entire part. The other one, the one made out of wood, if it's part hot, it's not affected the entire part.
One of them conducts heat, the other one doesn't.
Yes. And you see it in a lot of different materials that mm-hmm. happens partially or fully.
Mm-hmm.
Then the Mishnah said, Venotenet Kra'av, so he placed the legs and the entrails inside the lamb's body and roasted them together. Tana, Rabbi Ishmael Koreo, Tuch, Tuch. So Rabbi Ishmael hold the same as Rabbi Yossi Aglili, that he put all these parts inside the animals, and when they hit inside the body of the offering, it sounds like it's cook. When you have popcorn, right? They make puck, 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 right? So the same here, that right. You hear these sounds. So Rashi here, there is a Rashi on that. And in my book, Birak Lomar Barashi, I explained this Rashi. When you use the tuch tuch, we do not have, we short in time, so I'm not going there. Anyway. Rabbi Tarfon Korehu Gdi Mekulas. Rabbi Tarfon called it a helmeted kid. It's Rabbi Tarfon hold that all these parts must be roasted when they are suspended from the spit above the head of the animal, that it right. Resemble a helmet.
Mm-hmm.
So it's called it in Hebrew Gdi Mekulas. So there's two avenues among the Rishonim here. What's the involved? The Ozer who are hold in Ilchot Psachim in 230, that they're only prohibited in that sense, in Gdi Mekulas. But others disagree. They said they can go by the regular way we just mentioned earlier. So the Gemara asks, Hashta yesh lomar, nechtach mimeno ever, if one part was cut, the afal gav de kamit veileba, even that part that was cut, it's roasted with the entire animal. Amar tlo, anyway, you said, no, you cannot use it, nishlak mibaya. If you cut it and you cook it, it's not considering gdi meshulat, because it can be o gdi or tale, it's either go to the other. Amar Rav Sheshet, Sheshlako Bimchubar. So we have two different dinim. The first dini is part Nechtach Ever, one of the limb, Muskat. So you roasted it separately and it's not considered Mekulas. The other option is you take the entire gdi, the entire goat, and you cook just one Eivar, one limb, and that's not considering mekulas. Amar Rabba, hay mulyeta sharia, this stuffing of raw meat inside another meat that is being roasted is okay, sharia, you can eat it, even if the meat that it's stuffed inside has not been salted to remove the blood. But you have blood in. That's applied to many avenues in halacha. The same way it's absorbed, it's dissolved. You remember when we talk about kashrus, and we said that the process is the same way it's absorbed, it can dissolve in a high temperature. Here we talk about the blood, the same way the blood swallowed, the meat swallowed the blood, the same way he is pulling out the blood, because the heat of the fire that come out of roasting the meat, it's basically it's involved also the blood that come from other sources. It's all coming. So neima mesayale, we bring a source, noten et kaaved neimav letocho, he put, place the legs and his entrails inside the peskalem and roasted them together. My tama, why we're not concerned that maybe this offering swallow from the blood of those piece part that inside? Have mishum amrinum kebolokach polto, not the same rules that the same is absorbed, it's emitted. So they said amrei, we explained shane hatam over there in the Mishnah, it's different. Kevan de ita beit hashchita, because they have a part in the throat of the animal that you cut. Dim mechalchel, that is hollow and open, because it's come down at the time of roasting it. Meidav daivei, all the blood is coming out toward the hole of the neck. It's coming out the place that you have the shchita, the slaughtering. Neima mesayale, bring another suggested source. Halev ko'o umotzi damo, take the heart of the animal and you tear it and remove the blood before one roast or cook it. Lo kra'o ko'o achar bishulo, if you do it before the cooking, you do it afterward, tearing it. Umutar, it's okay, my tama, because you have now issue of the blood that comes inside the heart. Lav mishum damrian kebolo kach palto. So you don't say the same rule that they observe it's omitted. Shanei lev, heart is different. Deshia, that it's smooth. It's not swallow the blood that coming inside it. So it speaks, Rashi said, blood that's already cooked. So blood that already cooked, because it's not, by the Torah law, it's not considering something that we observe it. There is a big discussion, Rambam and Ravid, etc. If that's the way we explain the Braita, or is it just under this circumstance? Anyway, Eini, is that correct? V'haravin sava tafle ahi bar gozala lerav. It was elderly person, elderly sage by the name of Rabin, that he wrapped together the gozala. It's a very young what
dove.
Is it? What dove?
Dove, yeah.
Thank you. And he wrapped it with a dough and he roasted. We call it pashtida. You see the nowadays you see that's stuff meat that they sell. So he served it. Amar lei, Rav said to him, if they bring a special taste with this extra dough that is cooked, give me and I'll eat it. So you may think that dough swallow some part of the blood from this while it's roasted, but if Rav hold that it's allowed to eat, must be that it's according to the rule, the same way it's absorbed, it's omitted. So now it's contradiction. So they said, "Hahi bismida," over there it's talk about fine flour, demi parir, that it can be a like a crumble, so the blood is coming out. But the regular dough that come regular flour may not bring out the blood that was swallowed inside it. That's the way Rashi explains. Rava ikla leveirish galuta. Here is another story that Rava came to the house of the exilier. Vetaflu le baravaza. They serving with a dough that inside was a da. Amar ilo de chazit de zig kezuza chivara. If I don't see the leaks that come out of the meat, that it's clear, like a brand new coin, mm-hmm. that's made out of clear of silver, lo ach lemine, I'll not eat it. So in other words, even I see a little redness right. in the bread, that see a sign of blood, I'll not eat it. So they said, if you tell me the same way, it's observed, it's omitted. My area kizig. So why you have to have a clear liquid? Afilu kilozig nami. Even it's not clear too. So they said hatam bichivarta deshari. Over there they speak about a clear like white flour. That is strong and is not bringing out the blood that swallowed there. Vehilcheta and the halacha, that if one makes the breading, this mida, if it's a fine flour, whether it turns red from the blood or did not turn red, ben asmik, ben lo asmik, sharia, you allow. Dechivarta, if it's a clear white coin, so they said izig kezuza chivara, if it's clear like white coin, sharia, you allow. V'ilo asir, but if not, it's prohibited. Dishar kmachim, if it's breading of other type of flour which are not especially firm or crumbly, asmik asur, if the breading turn red, it's prohibited. Lo asmik, if it's not turn red, shari, it's permitted. So, because it bring out the blood. Hai mulyeta, that this meat stuffing in an animal, man de asar, the one who's prohibited to want to eat it, afilu puma letachat, even that you roasted, that the mouth is toward the part for down below, man de shari, and one to allow it, afilu puma leel, even the mouth is to the top, vehilcheta, and the halacha is mulyata shari. This, that stuffing is permitted, even afilu puma le'el, even the opening is facing upward. That's according to the lenient opinion. Umtza, if you have a live meat, because the animal was hit while it was alive. Be'e, the egg of a male, umizrike, those vein in the throat, pligeba Rav Acha v'Ravina. Rav Acha v'Ravina have a disputation over that. So the Gemara comment, b'chol haTorah kula, any time that you have Amoraic disputation, so one is more stringent and one is more lenient, and we don't know who is the stringent and who is the lenient, you should know that Rav Acha lechumra v'Ravina lekula. But usually you go, Rav Acha is more stringent and Ravina is more lenient. V'hilcheta ki Ravina lekula. We're going lenient by Ravina. Levar me'anet la'ad, excluding from these three, which is umtza, b'a, umizrike. V'Rav Acha lekula, ורבינה לחומרה, ואילכתה כרב אחה לכולה. יגו ברב אחה, לינין. אז לגמור הסד, היי אומצא דאיסמיק, this piece of raw meat that became red from the blood inside it, חתכי, if he cut, ומלכי, you put the salt, אפילו כדרה שרי, you can even put it in a regular pot, because by doing the salt, all the blood come out. I don't know if you remember, but years back, I remember in my childhood, going back about 40 some years ago, so mom used to put...
Oh, yes, you know, salt and soak the meat.
Heavy salt.
Yeah, absolutely,
meat,
yeah.
The that blood was... out, etc.
Yep.
Shavdei b'shapuda. And then you roasted it inside the stove. Shavdei, you allow it. Meidav dayev, the blood had come out while you roasted it. Achtei agumrei, you leave it on the coal and roast it. Plige baravacha veravina. This is a machloket between ravacha and ravina. Chad asar vechad sharei. One allow, one forbids. Man de asar, the one who said that the heat that come out of the coal, matzmit tzamit, it's bring... he squeezed the meat. So what happened is the blood is not coming out. It squeezed and hold it tight.
Okay.
So imagine, just for our understanding, imagine you have meat and you left it out overnight. Or you take, good example is schnitzel. Let's say you left somehow schnitzel overnight, open, not in a heat, not in any temperature. Sooner or later you see the meat became smaller and squeezed. Mm-hmm. And it's tight.
Contract.
Thank you. That's the word. So that's the story. Uman de Shari, the one who allowed, he said that the hate that come out of those coals, mish av shayiv, it's bring the blood from inside, and therefore the meat can be eaten. The hilchetah, and we go by the one who is lenient, mish av shayiv. We have the blood that was basically comes that way. The chen be'e, also the male eggs, chatchinu malchinu, you cut and you salted it, afilu legdera asharia, the same way you can put it on a pot and it's okay. Why? Says, talinu b'shapuda, so basically what they said is, in the usual manner of this, it's not enough to salt them, but you need also to cut. Aruch HaShulchan in Yoreh Deah, Samechei 65 said that it's not sufficient just to salt it, but you need to cut it as
well.
You
need to open them up.
Right, because the blood is there and you don't see it. Now, he said here, Talinu b'shipuda, if he hang it on the dat shapud. So he said, Sharyan, we allow, meidav daye, because the blood is coming out while you're roasting it. Achtinu agam agumrei, but if you leave it on the coal and roasted, pligeba rav acha veravina, it's the disputation between rav acha and ravina. Chad asar vechad shariman de asar matzmit tzamit. Again, he says that it's contracted and the blood, it's inside. Mandeshare Mishav Shari, he says that coming out. That's we're going by Rav Acha, that is more lenient. Vechen Mizrike. Now we go to the third case. So we talk about the vein that it's in the throat. Chatcheyu Malche. You have to cut it and put the salt. Afilu Ligdera Shari. You can cook it afterward, even with the pot. Talye Beshapuda. If you hang the animal on that shapud and roast it, in beit hashchita, if the place that you shocheted it, which is the throat part, let tatae, when it's come toward below, share those veins allow. Why? Made of dive, because the blood is coming out toward this cut, achtei agumrei, but if you put it on a coal and roasted it, פליגי רבחה ורבינה, חד עשר וחד שרי, מן דה עשר מעצמי צמיד, ומן דה שרי מישה שבי, ולכתה מישה שעיים. Again, that we go by הלכה, that the heat of the coals draws out the blood, and it's permitted. So now we continue with the umtza. Hi umtza. So the Tosfot tells us here that if you have a blood that absorbs in the meat, people will soak raw meat in vinegar in order to ensure that none of the blood will separate from its original place and prohibit the meat from being eaten. It's permitted to eat blood that it's not separate from its original place. So they said, Hai umtza, the asmik chalye, they have the raw meat that was vinegar become red due to the blood that absorbed it. So they had, so they said it's prohibited, forbidden. Chali asir, lo asmik, if the vinegar did not become red.
The gravy.
What?
The gravy.
Gravy.
Yeah, the sauce or the gravy,
right.
Yeah.
Chali eshari, so it's okay, it's permitted. Ravina amar afilu lo asmik. Ravina said even it's not become red. Nam echali asir, also it's prohibited. Why? I efshar delet bashu yarki dema, because it can be that it does not have a streak of blood. So here, have here all the mahalach in the Tosfot, but basically they said that. You have the issue of this part of the blood. Amar leimar bar ameimar leravashi. So the Gemara add another point. Abba, which is ameimar, megama legamue. He used to swallow the vinegar that was unconcerned that they made blood in it. So Ravashi have here explanation that it's he put it with the vinegar and then he used it. There are those, most of the Rishonim hold, like the Rif and the Rambam and the Ravid, they say that it's alive. But anyway, Ika de'amre Rav Ashi gufei megama legamue. Rav Ashi himself used to swallow it. So it's a Gemara in Chulin, Kuf Yud Alef 111, that have a discussion over that. Amar le mar bar amemar le rabashi. Hai chala de chalit beichad azimna. This vinegar that he combined it with the roasted meat one time in order to pull out the blood. Tu lo tanei chalit be. So you not soak meat in it again. It could no longer keep the blood in the meat. So, because this vinegar, if you put it even one time, it's already...
It gets weak.
Maishna, mechala tamha. What's the difference between this one and the one we soak without any concern that it's unable to keep the blood in the meat? We said, that we put this roasted meat, hatam over there, you talk about weak vinegar, ite ein hay 75 lekiyuha de feira beene, that sharpens the fruit remain present in a vinegar, in its pure, unadulterated form, despite the fact that the vinegar itself is not sharp. And that's basically a Rashi. So it says that it by itself it can hold the blood. But here the sharpness of the fruit does not remain present in a vinegar, and therefore it's pure, because it's already took part, Rashi said, of the vinegar. Rambam, Hilchot Korban Pesach, chapter 8. The Paschal lamb is roasted in the following manner. A wooden spit is inserted into the lamb, and it's then roasted over an open fire. A spit fashioned out of pomegranate wood is preferred because it does not secrete water, and therefore there is no concern that the meat will be cooked. Since the Rambam did not quote the future qualifications for the spit mentioned by the Gemara, it appeared, that's the Kesef Mishnah said, that it did not consider them to be accepted by halachic requirements. the legs and the entrails of the Paschal lamb are hung next to it in speed. None of the entrails are left inside, so as to ensure that they will not be cooked. The halacha is according to the opinion of Rabbi Akiva, in keeping with the principle that in his accepted opinion, in dispute with those individual sages. The Paschal lamb may not be roasted on the metal spit, because the metal is heated by the fire to the point that the meat roasted by the heat of the spit, and not directly by the fire. And it's not the way that the Torah asks to do it. we said although wherever it is customary not to eat roasted meat on the night of Passover, one may not eat roasted meat. Even the places in which custom is permitted eating roasted meat, it is prohibited to consume a kid or lamb that is roasted whole. However, if it cut into pieces, or if part it is missing, or one of its limbs is boiled, it's no longer considered a kid roasted whole, and may be eaten on the night of Pesach, and that's the Rambam, Hilchot Chametz U'Matzah, chapter 8. now, we speak about the meat that cover with the dough. So the Rambam, ruling according to the Gemara, states, if one spread dough on the top meat, the breading status depend upon the circumstances. If the dough is made from flour whose practicals are large, it may be eaten. If it's made from a finely ground flour, it is prohibited to eat it. However, if the breading is made from a regular flour, it is permitted to eat if the breading did not turn red at all. Nevertheless, the Shulchan Aruch, based on Shibolei Leket, rules that nowadays no one is sufficiently expert to make this distinction, and consequently, it is always prohibited to eat the flour. Nevertheless, if the meat is salted first and allowed to sit for the appropriate amount of time, it is always permitted to eat it. That's the Rambam in Chod Machalot Asurot, chapter 6, in Shulchan Aruch Yoreh Deah, 78. Now, we said also, in regard to raw meat, if an animal suffered a wound that resulted in a visible issue of a hemorrhage, it is prohibited to cook the section of the meat until it's cut open and salted well. However, it's permitted to roast it over fire, even if one does not cut and salt it. That's the way that Rabbeinu Gershom and the Rosh hold, not Shulchan Aruch Yoreh Deah, chapter 67.